Today I'm going to talk a bit more in depth about the electric engine from Decathlon. First of all, I was lucky enough to be an official product tester for the FLTB9. So I got all this gear for a while back. I've been testing it for quite a long time for the flow tube. The engine, not so long. I had it in the winter time, so I couldn't really use it in the situation that a lot of people are interested, especially weeds and speed and all that. So I'm not paid by Decathlon, by the way. I just got the flow tube for free and was happy enough to participate in that project and give them my honest opinion on that flow tube. But today the video is about that electric engine. So as you can see, this one is a prototype because it still has the black propeller. The one you would be buying normally have, I think, an orange propeller on them. So power of that engine, it's not put on the Decathlon website how many pound of power it has. I would suggest it has about maybe 25 pounds of power, 20-25 pounds, which is, I think, plenty enough for a flow tube, because any faster the flow tube will start to get really hard to control, because you're controlling the direction with your fins. So it depends on how you move your feet, you steer the flow tube like that. So I think anything more powerful than that, it'll be hard to steer the flow tube. You could get into trouble in wavy conditions, and I think just for safety, that's why they kind of topped that at that kind of power. So there's always the solution if you want to put another engine with a stick-on pad at the back. There's different brands that make it with the bracket, so you can put a normal electric engine, but honestly, I wouldn't go that way. Tried that engine in current, in rivers. It's powerful enough to get you by. It's not a Formula One. You're not going to break any speed limit with it, that's for sure. But it gets you there and it saves your legs. And that's all I ask from a small engine like that. So top speed. Again, I think for safety, it's not an overpowered engine, so you're not going to drown yourself. I had it fully loaded. Battery is a normal leisure battery, so it's a heavy battery. It's a 75 amp that I use, plus all the gear, spare rods and everything. So I'm about, I don't know, 85 kilo, 90 kilo, plus everything on it. So I tried it with the flow tube really heavy, and top speed was about 4 or 5 kilometers per hour on the slightly windy conditions. I suggest if you travel light, you probably reach about 6, maybe 7 kilometers per hour. How does it go in weed? That's the big main questions. So I suppose on thick weed, like lily pads, anything that has a stem, floating weeds like that, the cage will protect the stems from going in. It'll just brush off and move away, and you get through, really fills up lily pads with goodies with it, without any too much trouble. Anything finer, anything like these big long weeds we have here, especially in rivers, they kind of tend to get sucked through the weed guard and then get wrapped inside the propeller like this. And I tried it in like really extremely weedy conditions the other day, and it didn't do well at all. But that was expected, because it's a small power engine, so it doesn't have the torque to chop through the weeds like a normal electric engine would do. And then the propeller is not designed for cutting weed, like on a main cutter or something like that. The propeller usually is designed to be a weed cutter at the same time. So it's a kind of sharp and different angle to chop the weed, a bit like a lawnmower. But this is just a simple little propeller, plastic propeller. It's not going to chop through much weed. So okay in moderate weedy conditions, but in thicker weeds, forget about it. I actually tried it so hard that I had so much weed wrapping around, and I wanted to see if the weed would get rid of itself by reversing or turning and not having to go underneath to free the propeller. Actually, it locked into its security mode. I suppose it's a good thing, because it stops the engine from overheating. The engine just cut off. but that's just a security feature, I think, on them. Like 2 minutes later, well, I suppose when he got back cooler, it started again and there was no problem. So weed, fair little bit of amount of weed, but not too much on them. That's the main thing. I suppose, yeah, again, if you want to go through weed or if you fish in really weedy conditions, mounting a normal electric engine at the back might do the trick for you. But then, I don't know, I don't really like to have the bar handle at the back. It's not practical. This is really practical as it is designed at the moment. Now, power consumption, like I said, I'm just using a normal leisure battery, slow release. It's 75 amp and it gets me through the whole day. I have no problem. I didn't run out of battery. Battery come home with still a good bit of power in it. So it's not bad on the battery. Like I said, it's not a big heavy engine. So battery, yeah, you get away with a 75. After, depend on the use. Everybody's different. If you fish rivers and you're against the current all day, and if you use it a lot, you might want something bigger and maybe invest into a lithium or something like that. But for me, perfect 75. It's not too heavy. You don't really feel it on the float tube, and it does the trick for the day. So that's basically the 2 points that I wanted to talk: power, speed, consumption, and the weed. So I banged it a few times as well too. So I kind of, when I get this product, I kind of trash them a bit around the place. I really don't take care of them, so I can see what they can, the abuse they can take. So I banged this one on rocks. There's a slight cosmetic. Don't know if the camera is gonna pick up, but there's a slight cosmetic scratches on the thing. Not too much damage, and that was a fairly big bang on the rock. So the plastic cover, the shelling is pretty tough. No problem with the cage at the moment. No problem with the propeller. I had no problem with anything. I think some people had problems with the connections coming off, but mine is still, the Anderson plug is still nice and solid. The connection is still really good in it, so I have no problem whatsoever. So all that is still working. Remote control is still working. So for the price, I think this retails for €250. I think it's great. It's a great little thing. Really helps you on the water. So up to you. If you don't like, if you want, I don't know. I know a lot of people are kind of, because it's Decathlon, they think it's like an AliExpress or Wish engine. It's not. It's a good, it's heavy. It's quality. I think it'll last a long time. And then the good thing that you have with Decathlon, of course, is that 2-year warranty no matter what. So you can bring it back if something happens. And usually they are very good for after-sales services. They'll change it or fix it, whatever. So that's it. They're on the market now. I think they've arrived in France, so they should start spread out to other shops like Ireland and things like that. I don't think in Ireland they're available yet, but probably maybe if you order them, they might ship them from France. I'm not too sure. But that's the Decathlon electric engine for the FLTB9 and the FLTB5 V2. So I don't know if the patches are going to come up for the glue on, so you can stick it to a normal float tube. So that's in the future, their future project. So that's about it. So if you have any other questions, put them in the comment below, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.